It takes more than one person to assist in a personal injury claim. I am attorney Glenn Westmoreland, and we have a strong team at the Mack Law Firm. It is our goal to make sure your injury is properly attended to. Contact me at tangylawteam.com and let us get you the help you need.
Well, congratulations on a great campaign. Didn't make the runoff, but you came close.
Yeah. Actually, Ken, if I would have got into this race back in November, December of this past year, I think things would have turned out a lot different. But I did throw my name in the hat a little late in the game. But we managed to get out there and still wound up with 22%, which I think was really good for a first-time politician, you know, campaigning.
Well, in the meantime, there are two left, obviously, and one for a week has been claiming to have your endorsement.
Yes, he has. Mr. David Ritter contacted me the night of the election, actually, after the polls had closed, and he found out that he was in the runoff. And he asked me to endorse him, and I told him that I was not going to endorse him, nor was I going to endorse Mr. Havis, since we had a really good, clean campaign going when we were out there beating the streets, that I would prefer to stay neutral in this process.
So the endorsement was not correct?
No, it was not. Not only that, there was a posting earlier this week that stated, in someone else's words, but it was worded to where it sounded like I was the one that wrote the posting, saying that I was endorsing Mr. Ritter, which I was not. And later on, when I contacted Mr. Ritter, I had a relative of mine contact me yesterday and tell me about the posting. So I had him send me a screenshot of it, because I don't have Facebook. And he sent me a screenshot of it, and I contacted Mr. Ritter, and I asked him, I said, you know, who gave you the authority to do this? And he said, well, he said, I had another guy post it for me, but he said that he wanted people to know that I was going to endorse him. And I said, well, that's a false statement. And I asked him exactly who it was that posted it for him. I thought it was one of his relatives that posted it for him. And later I find out that it was Mr. Louis Rufino that posted it, because he actually created the Facebook page for David Ritter Campaign Group. And Mr. Rufino was the one that actually posted it. And I asked Mr. Ritter to contact Mr. Rufino and put out a retraction out there. And he actually said no. He said if he wanted it retracted and do a different posting as justification, that I would have to contact Mr. Rufino myself. And at that point, that's when I told him, I said, well, I know what I have to do, which is the reason why I'm sitting here with you right now.
Well, I can tell that you're angry about this.
I am. I'm very upset about it. That's because we ran such a clean race. And the one thing that I strived on was to keep it clean. And I wanted no mudslinging, no ill will, you know, between us three. And now this happens. And really, this really, really upsets me. Not to mention that it's a false statement out there that I did not make. And I would like an apology from Mr. Rufino. And I expect an apology from Mr. Rufino. If not, then I'll have to see him face to face.
Well, what is what do you find so upsetting about this?
Well, it's discouraging to know. I've been knowing David Ritter all my life, since we were kids. And we all, you know, growing up, all of us gets into a little of this and a little of that. But I wouldn't have thought that David would have went this far to do such. Even, you know, especially after I made the statement three different times, not once, not twice, but three different times, that I was not going to endorse him, nor was I going to endorse Mr. Havis. As a matter of fact, I contacted Mr. Havis yesterday afternoon just to let him know what had transpired. And Joe told me that he had already saw it on Facebook and couldn't believe it. And I told him, I said, well, that's a good thing, because it's not true. You know, and I just told Joe, you know, good luck in the campaign. And we're gonna see where this goes.
So what are you going to do now?
Well, I'm going to wait on the apology, number one. But and again, I'm not going to endorse either one of them. But at first, I was very, very questionable on who I was going to support. And now it's not a question in my mind who I'm going to support. And I don't even have to say. But I will continue to be publicly active in the parish. Just because I lost a campaign doesn't mean I'm not going to be publicly active. I'm going to continue to be publicly active. One of the major reasons why I want this aired and to let people know is because later on, when there's other elections, there's a possibility that I may get out there and run again. And I don't want people thinking that I was supporting someone that would do something like this, really. I don't want that. I don't want that dirt on my carpet. I really don't. I want to continue to stay. I want this to continue to stay a clean race, but I wasn't the one through the mud.
What else do you want to tell us?
Well, the main thing that I want to say at this point is I want to thank each and every resident out there who supported me, who voted for me. I really appreciate your support. And if I decide to run again in the future, I would appreciate your support again. And I'm not only just talking about the people who voted for me, I'm talking about the people who did not vote for me, who later on would possibly consider me, you know, for the next election.
Because you have quite the resume in public service.
Yes, I do. Matter of fact, I have more qualifications than either one of the candidates now. That's not to say that one or the other can't do the job, but it would have been a lot smoother and a lot easier if I could have got in there and hit the ground running, because I've already worked at Tangipahoa Parish Government, and I know everybody inside Tangipahoa Parish Government, in the administration, and the bidding process, the grant process, and it would have just been a lot easier, you know, transition into the parish government.
So it's fair to say that you are going to vote for Joe Hafis.
Well, I didn't say that. You did. But I did say that people should be convinced as to who I'm going to vote for now.
Those of us who call Tangipahoa home, we know our parish is changing. Our population is booming. More people means the reality of more and more crime. We deserve a sheriff's office that's ready to face that challenge. And as a local guy whose roots here run deep, I'm ready to put my experience, training, and passion to work and lead our sheriff's office into one prepared for the future.